Welcome back to another edition of Fly Tying for Beginners. Today we're going to tie a really simple but very effective nymph, and that is the beadhead pheasant tail. The hook I have in a vise is a 5262. This is a size 12, and this is two extra long, two extra heavy nymph hook. This is by Green Caddis Outfitters, greencaddis.com. I have a 3mm copper bead. And I'm going to start out by adding more weight, lead-free 15/1000ths wire. And I'm going to start this around in, just in back of the middle. And we're going to put maybe about 15 wraps on here, depending on how deep you need it to go. And when we break off the front, we're going to push that up inside the bead. And we should have about half of the forward shank covered. Now I'm going to use brown. This is 8/0, 70 denier. It's red. I'm going to start behind the lead wraps. And we want to make a taper going up there. Then we're going to wrap up the lead wraps and back down. And I'm going to take the thread to the rear of the hook. Keep that tag end at a 45 degree angle. And we're going to stop right where the thread would hang at the barb of the hook. Okay, we're going to start with the tail, and for the tail I'm going to use pheasant tail center. It's a nice long one, and I'm going to take the ones off the bottom for the tail, like this section right here, because it has a nice color to it. You can see on here, these are stiffer than the inside. That's all web, all of this inside is web until you get close to the top, and then it's stiff pretty much the whole thing. We're going to take them. I have maybe 8, and we want to measure them from the back of the bead to the bend for our tail. Go ahead and tie this on. Just give it a couple of wraps. I think I want to shorten that even a little bit more. Give it a wrap underneath. Pick that tail up just nice. I'm going to wrap this in. And I'm going to come all the way up to the bead, wrapping it in. Then I'm going to fold this back. I'm going to wrap it down again until I reach the end of the thorax, which would be just about the end of the lead wraps. And that adds a little bit of width to the front. Now I'm going to take a fine copper wire, and you can use up to a medium copper wire depending on how much rib you want to be exposed. It reveals the size of your copper wire. I'm going to wrap this into the rear all the way to the tail, and I'm keeping it on my side of the hook. I'm going to take another piece of the pheasant tail center, and I want these from the top, more or less. We want all of the stiff ones. And I have about 8 barbels. I'm going to tie these in by the tip. And bring the thread to the top of the abdomen, which would be just on top of the lead wraps. Now we can take a little bit of head cement and put it on the shank, and this will help to secure the abdomen. Oop, I lost one. Take our hackle pliers and just give it maybe a one turn so that it doesn't split. As in, you can see right there, it's splitting. And as you rotate, the pheasant tail is going to twist on its own. We're going to bring that right up to the top. I'm going to tie that in at the top. And I'm going to tie these in closer to the bead, and then I'm going to trim them off. And that will give us just a little bit more thickness on our thorax. Now we're going to take our fine copper wire, and we're going to counter wrap, being the opposite direction we wrapped the pheasant tail. And we're making open palmers. And when we reach the top of the thorax, we could go ahead and tie that off. And with the fine copper wire, you could just break it off. Bring our thread back. Now you can see the pheasant tail is wrapped in one direction and the wire is wrapped in another direction. So here's the pheasant tail and here's the wire going over it. So it has a good secure style of wrap. Now I'm going to take another section of pheasant tail, and this time I have more. I took maybe 20 fibers and I'm going to use the tips for the legs. So I want the tips to extend past the bead the length of the leg that we want. So if we want the leg to be that long, we want it to extend past the bead that much. And we're going to tie that in right on top. And we're going to wrap forward. And then we're going to leave them right there in the front. And bring our thread back. Now we're going to take peacock frill, and we want really long ones. The longest ones you have. Now we're going to take a pair of these. And we're going to tie these in by the tip. And this peacock frill is probably 10 inches. Now when we reach the front, we can divide the legs. And divide these evenly. And I'm going to divide them, holding them and wrapping them down. Get the other side. And we're doing kind of a crossover wrap here. And we should have something similar to that. It's okay if they're even at a 90 degree angle. Now before we take our peacock curl, I'm going to put some head cement on the thorax. Should always use some head cement before you wrap peacock frill. That gives additional security in the wraps. Oop. Yeah, my legs are kind of getting in the way. I'm going to push them forward a bit. And we're going to wrap this. Now we're going to come up and back. And then we're going to move up once again. Then when we get to the legs, fold the legs to the side where you want them and wrap one in front. Come around in front once again. And then we can tie the peacock curl off. Put a couple of wraps in back and put a couple of wraps in front. Then you should be able to break them off. Now we take our wing case. We're going to fold that over. Pull back on the wing case. That will help you to sink it. Sink the thread. Put a couple of wraps in front of that wing case. Remove the excess. Take our whip finisher. And about a 3-turn whip finish is good enough. And we're going to remove the thread. Take our head cement one last time. Coat the wing case and put some head cement. You can get it on the bead and go right around with that. And here we have a bead head pheasant tail nymph. Simple but very effective nymph pattern. Hope that you learned something from this video. Hope you would subscribe to my channel. Please refer me to your friends. Leave comments, questions, suggestions, and most of all, thank you very much for watching my videos.